Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. So I got the request to do the Dasamsa chart video, and I thought I will just provide you the tool of very important and essential rules which I'm using always in my chart analysis to help me evaluate the career life of the person. So if you like the video, please hit the like button, and if you'd like to be notified about similar videos in the future, please click the subscribe button with the bell notification. So let's go straight to these questions. Okay, so the set will be related to questions such as: should I be employed or rather having my own company? What target should I aim? What sector should I look for a job? Where is my best fulfillment? How I can get it? What about success? Can I be wealthy in my profession? Is it in my destiny? What can I do to increase my productivity? About vacation and such similar questions, which give you a broad idea about the career life destiny of the person based on the Vedic astrology chart. So let's go. The first question is about: should I be employed or rather should I have my own business? So here we are just opening the Dasamsa chart and we are comparing the sixth house with the seventh house. Is it more strong and is it more favorable? So these two questions we have to answer. And then the next step can be comparing the Saturn, which is the significator for service, more employment, and Mercury, which is more for business. We can also see how these two planets are placed in the Dasamsa chart. And then we are looking for a Lagna Lord, because Lagna Lord can also decide what is our preferences. Lagna is the ascendant. So we are looking in the specific career life chart called Dasamsa for the Lagna Lord, and we are seeing its position. For example, if it's in six, of course it will support more employment. If it's in seventh, we are having the natural preference for business. But we can also look for a Lagna Lord supporting the fifth house, then it will also support more employment. If Lagna Lord is in ninth house, then we are more independent and we want to have our own company, freelance business, and so on. So this is the first question. The next question is about target. What kind of people should we aim for when we are having the company, business? So here we are looking at 11th from Arudra Lagna, and we can use various type of axes, various types of topology. For example, we can see the Moon and Jupiter, for Jupiter being people who are more expertise and Moon being the general people, which include also the beginners. So if you have, for example, 11th house from Arudra Lagna with the Jupiter, it has to do more with people who are expertise. So you can be a teacher of the teachers. For example, if you're an astrologer and you have Jupiter in 11th from Arudra Lagna, you can be teaching another astrologers. If you have Moon, then you can be doing consultation for people, you are helping people. So in this way, we can also specify more the aim or the target of our company or business. The next question is about: when should I start? What is the good time? So for this, we need, of course, the wave of fortune. The fortune chart is in Abhamsha, so we are seeing the placement of the actual planet, which is acting now in the Dasamsa. We are looking from the 10th house. If it's well placed, then it's a good time to start. If it's badly placed, we should wait for another dasha. The next important question is about the sector. So for example, we can be an engineer, but we can work in academia, we can work in marketing, we can work for government, we can work for medical or charity or social sector. So that all depends on the planet which is activating the Arudra Lagna. For example, if you have Mars activating the Arudra Lagna, then the IT sector is very good for you. If it's Mercury, it's more about commercial sector. If it's Venus, it's more about marketing and advertisement and so on. So in this way, you can specify to what kind of sector you should aim for. The next question is about productivity and efficiency. For that, we are looking for a 10th lord from the Janava Lagna, from the birth ascendant, because the 10th from the Moon will show more about description of our job, but how we are doing, how we are working, how we are using our body, our senses. It's more about the 10th lord from Lagna. So we are just analyzing the yogas, all the planets in the relationship with the 10th lord. For example, we can see if the Venus is connected with the 10th lord in Rashi, in the Navamshadan, person may use a lot of visuals, a lot of media in his job. If it's, for example, 10th lord in the 5th house, we can use also the houses. For example, then the 10th from the 5th will be the 2nd house, so the mouth, the speech, because the 2nd house represents our speech. So because the 10th lord is in the 5th house, then the speech will be very important for us to work. So based on the 10th lord, we can increase our potential and productivity. So the next four questions are very important now, because they show if the career life will be a vital part of our life, if we can be fulfilled, if we can achieve success, and if we can be wealthy in our business or employment. So first question is about a vital part of our life. So for this, we are looking just for Mercury and Arudra Lagna. What is the position? If spiritual people often have the Mercury in the 3rd or 6th from the Arudra Lagna, because it shows the Pravraja, the renunciation of the Mercury. And the Mercury rules all the career sector, all that grinding for work, for money. We want to be sustained. And also this gives us greed. That greed translates into this drive and stamina for us to be better and better, to increase our productivity. And this is all Mercury, which is also about the learning curve, how we are improving our skills. Therefore, this Mercury is the Karaka, the significator for the 10th house. So if Mercury is well placed from the Arudha Lagna, then this play an important role in your life, because Arudha Lagna is how you perceive yourself and also how others perceive you. And if the Mercury is badly placed, like third, sixth or 12th, then that aspect of life may not be important for you. It's also okay. Other aspects like spirituality, education, family life, charity, helping others, all the other aspects may be more important for you then. So the next question is about being fulfilled. So fulfilled means that we are having all these internal significators or internal life in sync with what is happening outside. So we are just looking for to integrate the elements which are related to a spiritual or more spirit elements related to our karma, how we are acting. Is there any meaning? So basically the Jupiter brings the meaning to our life because it's the significator of jnana or knowledge. And then what we have to do, we have to see what is the sambandha or connection between those elements, like Amatya Karaka, which is related to how our spirit perceives the mission, the karma, whatever we do. We can also see the Atma Karaka for the soul, and the Karana, which is the special point, which is the half of the Titi or the lunar day. This is also important to show what kind of karma we are being born for. And then also we have to see, for example, Shubhapati, which is showing how our mind is interacting with whatever we do. So if we have found the circumstances of our work, for example, 10th from Moon, what the society wants to give us, then we can connect these points, how much this also is in sync with our fulfillment. So about the success, if we have the chart which promotes and guarantees the easy way, easy steps for success, for this, there are specific groups of yogas, which is called Raja Yoga. Raja means success. So Raja Yoga, the basic one, because there are many of them across the texts, astrological texts called Shastras. So there are, the basic one are when the Kendra Lords are with the Trikona Lords. So Kendra Lords are first, fifth, first, fourth, seventh, and tenth, and the Trikona is first, fifth, and ninth. When these lords of these houses are connected, they are forming yoga, and there are three types of yoga. There is the conjunction, so being in one house, then we have the aspect, which is called Drishti, and then we have the Parivartana, which is the exchange, for example, Venus being in Marshall sign like Scorpio, and Mars being in a Venusian sign like Libra. So they exchange their placements. This is the strongest type of connection, this Parivartana. So when then occurs this yoga, which is the connection between the Kendra Lords, first, fourth, seventh, tenth, and Trikona, first, fifth, and ninth, then the Raja Yoga is formed. And then we can see which house the yoga is formed, where it is, what sign, which planets, and then this can give us information what part of our career life to activate to achieve that success. So the next question is about the wealth, and of course everyone knows that in astrology it's very hard to really quantify the amount of wealth person can get, some kind of karmic limits. It's very important. Of course there are attempts to that. For example, in Brihat Parashara Shastra, in the second house chapter, Parashara Muni is giving such proposition to amount of wealth, but we know that it's very hard. But we can definitely say that there are yogas which are showing people who have extraordinary or huge wealth. For this, normally what we are expect is the 11th from Arudha Lagna having the Atma Karaka, debilitated planet or exalted planet connected to this point. The last three questions are about when we can get the job, about popularity and vacations. So when we can get the job, it's about the fifth house and the fifth lord. We need to see their position, and when the Dasha, which is the planet which is active in the time, is activating this fifth house and the fifth lord, of course we are looking that in the Dashamsa, in the career life chart, then it's a time to get new job. Or if we have already the job, then normally it shows the promotion. About the popularity, we also have a set of yogas, but the basic one is Jupiter and Moon, when it's influencing first and seventh from the Lagna or the Arudha Lagna. And then we have the connection between Lagna, which is the ascendant, and the Arudha Lagna. If there is the connection, then this promotes the person being popular, being famous. And we know also that the planet, which will connect these two points, will show how this happens. For example, if it's Mercury, it has to do with speaking, with communicating, also with writing. So if it's Jupiter, it's more about teaching, about giving the knowledge. So more the idea about bringing some ideas, giving the meaning. So the Jupiter is more about that. If it's Venus, then it can be related to some kind of entertainment. If it's Saturn, it can be inheritance, or it can be service. You can be some important assistance or servant to someone, and so on. So in this way, we are evaluating these points. The last point about the vacation, this is very easy, but also very important. Third house in the Dasamsha chart, when that is activated by Drishti or yoga, any type of connection, then we have a time for vacation. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you find this interesting. Please click the like button if you like it, and subscribe for more, and see you in the next one.